This part work has been supplied to me free of charge from DeAgostini. If you'd like to build along, pop along to DeAgostini.com where you can order one for your very own. They also have several other part work build up models that you can build for everything from cars to boats and everything in between. So I'd like to thank them very much for giving me the opportunity to build this so you can all watch and see exactly how it all goes together. Hello, I'm Chris. This is Gross Models. Welcome to issue 93 of building the Ford GT from DeAgostini. In this issue, we're doing a little bit more bumper work. We're putting the lights into the bumper and preparing for the bigger headlights to come in as well. After, of course, looking through the magazine, the Cortina. Cortina Lotus. I don't know the Cortina Lotus. It's different. Feel free to look at all the words in there. I won't be reading it myself. I'm only here for the building. But if you want to read the words, then that's what they're for. Yes, this is what we've got. We've got some bulbs, a bulb cover, and we're digging out the bumper assembly, fitting the bulbs into that, and then putting it away. Next week, we're doing exactly the same on the other side, so that's a nice, easy one to get into. So let's see how it works. Let's get to it now. Right, here we have a bulb and a bulb cover, the lens cover for the front. And the front is what we are dealing with on this one. I can say it's only going to fit on one side, and it is this side. So this is the side we're working on. I'm not entirely certain what it means when it says the longer one. I would assume, I don't know, that's technically longer than that one is, but also the hole that it's going to fit through is down the bottom there. So I'm going to use this one to go into the bulb that we've actually got there and leave that loose one to go up to the headlamp assembly, purely because it feels like that's the way it's going to be mounted in, because the hole's going to come out here, which is closer to this one than it is to the other one. No, wait, because the hole, rest of it comes out through there. So no, the lone bulb I'm going to put through into there first. Yeah, a little bit misleading when it says about long and short of it all. But basically it says to fit that one in there and then put everything through there. But the rest of it's going to be here, isn't it? The front assembly thing. We'll find out when we put the other bit on there, but the bulb itself is just going to go into the bulb there. A pair of tweezers will help that. If I can get a pair of tweezers that's going to let me grip it nicely. What have I got? I've got lots of tweezers around here, but none of them seem to be ideal. That will do it, I think. And then I can grab the sides of the bulb like so. Line it up with the hole that it's got to go into. Is there, and that will go in there. So that's in that bulb, which will illuminate nicely. The cover goes over the front, locates in on both sides. Good. Basically just pop in place, I think. Seems to be the plan. No. Didn't want to line up properly. Got to be that side. What am I doing on the wrong side? No, it's got to be that side because that's definitely shaped more that way. That goes in down there. And that will go in over there. That's not a great fit. I'm not convinced. Right on this side. Yeah, that's a better shape over that side. I've done that in the bulb in completely on the wrong side. Not going to matter, but I will change it over just in case it does matter. It's thinking left and right anyway, but this is up that way, so it's only going to come through this side. So I might be, yeah, because that's the underneath, not the inside. Dealing with it all backwards. So ignore everything I've said, because I think I've done it completely wrong. That will go in there like that. That bulb will come out of there. And we'll come over this side. So, yes, I am in fact going to use the one that's attached to the bulb and the wire to go in there on this side. Going to go in there. Just like it did on the other side, but on this side. If I can get that lined up now. I can't. I could play with that and get that lined up. So that wire is now going to come out through there. But this wire isn't. This one is going to come up into the top assembly. So I'll figure out why that's not going in there and get that sorted out. But then we'll see how it works next time. It will be much smoother and better, I'm sure. So thank you for watching. Join me tomorrow or the next day for the next part. I'll see you soon. Bye-bye for now.